explains the reason why this place is like this. Our program are not funded by anybody, and I repeat, by anybody. Allegation of fraud, misappropriation, and mismanagement at FIRS. The essence of taxation in development of any country worldwide cannot be overemphasized. The law mandates all Nigerian businesses, companies, and corporate bodies to pay tax. That is the law. Whatever typographical error does help us to amend or correct. Federal Inland Revenue Service, FIRS, is an establishment mandated to collect tax on behalf of federal government. It has autonomy to run its affairs. By virtue of FIRS Act 13 of 2007, it has power on administration of tax and power to enforce. It is of paramount importance that agencies of the government, more especially those of which the PIFOT, those on which the PIFOT or finance of the government rotates, must be very prudent in management of resources. Hence, Nigeria's government relies seriously on Federal Inland Revenue Service, Executive Chairman. Hence, Nigerians and government rely seriously on Federal Inland Revenue Service. Executive Chairman of FIRS, beyond being a professional and an expert in taxation matters, is also expected to be a person of high integrity, prudency. It is of paramount importance that agencies of the government, more especially those on which the pivot of finance of the government rotates, must be very prudent in management of resources. Hence, Nigerian government relies seriously on Federal Inland Revenue Service. Executive Chairman of FIRS, beyond being a professional and an expert of the taxation matter, is also intended to be a person of high integrity. Mamman Nami, that is the name of the Executive Chairman of Federal Inland Revenue Service, the incumbent chairman. Mamman Nami, as the Executive Chairman of Federal Inland Revenue Service, has been in the news due to several allegations as to various infractions at FIRS, which he heads. It must be recalled that Mamman Nami was appointed by President Muhammadu Buhari to replace Mr. Babatunde Fowler. It is expected that Mamman Nami will continue where Mr. Babatunde Fowler stopped. But in the wisdom of the Executive Chairman of FIRS, he decides to adopt his own system by recruiting new hands, within quotes, to replace some old hands. Recruitment of new hands. Directors and different agencies of the government are part of the management and must be employed in accordance with laid down rules and regulations of public service. However, when Mamman Nami employed four directors without regards for public service rule and internal regulation. When Mamman Nami did not only fail to advertise the position to enable qualified Nigerians compete for the positions, FIRS staff that were qualified to occupy the seats were also not given the opportunities. This is against the rule as far as federal civil service is concerned. May we state, Nigeria is governed by the rule of law and respect for constituted authority, more especially the presidency. However, Nami recruitment of the directors were also against the presidential directive of 2016 that now makes it possible for directors and permanent secretaries in public service to stay beyond two tenures. President letter, we saw with reference S100A1462 dated 17 June 2016, was conferred to all heads of federal ministries and agencies with memo signed by Winifred Oyo Ita. The number of that memo is also stated here clearly. So to enable you, the journalist, make further verification. CACOBAG, just like the committee, CACOBAG, just like the Committee for Workers' Rights, CWR, and Nigerian Labour Congress, frowned. Frowns at the system of hiring staff on contract. It is either meant to pay them slave wages or employed to hash a plan. Those of you that are very close to us, we know that when we talk about workers' rights, Committee for Workers' Rights, and United Action for Democracy, then United Action for Democracy, including CDHR, cannot be relegated as far as the struggle for workers' rights are concerned. And when you look at all the conventions, all the ILO conventions, it is against contract and casual labor. But this goes beyond that. Mamman Nami employed 4 contract staff after sacking 8 directors and later converted the contract staff to directors. That is, the contract that were hired by him were later converted to directors. Mind you, directors are senior management positions as far as agencies and practices of the government are concerned. To CACOBAG, corruption is not limited to financial dealings alone. It could also be attitudinal and or moral. Violation of rule of law, rules and guidelines of an established agency of the government is a serious infraction which should not be taken lightly. And that's one of the reasons why we are addressing the press. The Eastern Public Service Rule 02102 made advertisement of senior management position mandatory before anyone could fill the position. It is not just an advertisement, but it must be in all national dailies to get all Nigerians informed of the existence of such vacancies to be filled. Mamman Nami needs to tell the world why he decided to deliberately ignore the rule that is meant to unite Nigerians, as such positions can be filled by any qualified Nigerian from any state of the Federation. You know, when we talk about federal character, though some of us may not agree with it in total, but to a certain extent, as far as things like this are concerned, we think it is still reasonable. The essence of advertisement is that they will give money to all Nigerians, regardless of where you are, regardless of your tribe, regardless of your religion, that so vacancy is existing at certain places of the and agencies of the government. But then, in the wisdom of the incumbent chairman, he failed to advertise. And when I talk about advertisement, the advertisement is left, it's not just for advertising sake. It must be advertised for 2 weeks. It must be advertised for 2 weeks. But this man failed to comply with this directive. By fact of section 2.22 subsection 1 of the Human Resource Protection Program, which is called HRPP, contract appointment can only be made if required experience or qualifications are not available within the service. If a started recruitment is to be made, it must be advertised for not less than 6 weeks. Mr. Mamman Nami must explain why he failed to comply with the rule. Circumvention of due process as to give preference to some people above other Nigeria while recruiting to senior management positions cannot and should not be tolerated. Why did Mr. Mamman Nami not elevate some deputy directors that have required experience and education to directors? That's a question for him. As at that moment, there were several deputy directors that have the prerequisite requirement, the qualification to be elevated to occupy the seats of directors at FIRS. But he decided to employ other people, which was also against the rule, the internal guidelines of FIRS. Autonomy of FIRS does not confer on Mamman Nami the power to disregard rule and the presidential directive. Nigerian president is an executive president whose executive power, within quote, is very superior to any other executive positions in Nigeria, including Mamman Nami executive chairman position in FIRS. Beyond that, is Mamman Nami not conscious of section 1.8.2 of HRPP, which says All extant circulars, directives, notice and or documents given for that details and or explanation of the position of HRPP shall form part of HRPP and should equally be binding. Like I said, kindly forgive us for those typographical errors. Allegation of fraud. Beyond flagrant abuse of power by Mamman Nami, several allegations were also in the public domain against him of mismanagement and or misappropriation of fund and or fraud. Mamman Nami was said to have chartered a private jet to Kigali and Dubai and other areas, which is against government and federal inland revenue service policies. Purchase of second-hand buses at highly ridiculous and exorbitant prices. Award of over 3 billion naira printing contract without regards to due process. Purchase of computers at hyperinflated prices. Production of surveillance at the cost of 1.7 billion naira, which is contrary to the standard rule of FIRS. CACOBAG calls on EFCC and ICBC to probe Mamman Nami now. And I repeat, CACOBAG calls on EFCC and ICBC to probe Mamman Nami now. Corruption allegation is an allegation that cannot and should not be relegated, neglected, or ignored. By factor of Section 50, Subsection 5 of the Constitution, which is very, very clear, not ambiguous, it says, the state shall abolish all corrupt practices and abuse of office. It is up to Nigerians to decide if Mamman Nami has abused his position as the executive chairman of FIRS. No doubt, abuse of power by Mamman Nami has to be investigated and to be substantiated. And I repeat, abuse of power by Mamman Nami has to be investigated as to be substantiated. Like I did say earlier on, the press test, how we talk about fraud, allegation, corruption, it's a serious crime as far as Nigeria is concerned. Why are we in this pillar government? It's because of corruption and nothing more. Before now, if you are able to acquire just only secondary school certificates, in fact, you are more or less a super person in Nigeria because employment will be waiting for you. But now, with your BBB, KKK, HHH, DDD, MMM, if care is not taken, what happens? You will still ride Okada. God forbid. So it is this good lack of mess, it is this corruption that has caused it. And that was a serious allegation. We are not accusing Mamman Nami because he has not been investigated. But then, in every allegation, there's always the iota of truth. And that's why he has to be investigated. This allegation has to be substantiated. And that is why, by virtue of the FCC Act and by virtue of the ICPC Act, they have the power to investigate Mamman Nami. And that's why we are calling on him to investigate. And if I want him, he must be probed and prosecuted. No doubt, abuse of power by Mamman Nami has to be investigated, has to be substantiated. This is why CACOBAG called the ICPC to take immediate action to investigate Mamman Nami. Financial Crime Commission Act, EFCC, Financial Crime Commission Act is also very clear. And in pursuance to EFCC Act, we call the FCC to commence immediate investigation of Mamman Nami. What we are trying to say there, you see, there are some Nigerians that seem to mix up the functions of ICPC and the EFCC. Both EFCC and ICPC are expected to fight corruption, but they have their specific functions. As far as this illegal and lawful recruitment at FIRS is concerned, it is the duty of ICPC. Just like it is the duty of ICPC to investigate politicians to have spent more money than what is stipulated by the electoral acts. But unfortunately, they have not been doing that. But other financial crime commission, fraud, and others are the duties of EFCC. Former petitions, I have them here, of CACOBAG to this effect, shall be submitted to both EFCC and the ICPC latest by tomorrow. That is, if not today. The fact against corruption should be a known old bad and must be holistic. President Muhammadu Buhari did not miss word when he said, we must all kill corruption. We don't want corruption to kill Nigeria. Even Mamman Nami is found wanting, after his investigation by both EFCC and ICPC, he should be prosecuted in the court of law to serve as deterrence to others. May we state categorically, if after the submission of our petitions and nothing is heard from both EFCC and ICPC, we shall not hesitate to approach the court to seek other mandamus for its investigation. Nigeria belongs to all of us, and nobody can arbitrarily use his power, use his executive position to hold the country to ransom. Thank you all. So our friends from the media, thank you for listening. That is the press test, and I want to believe it is very, very clear beyond the banner that we have behind us. Federal Inland Revenue Service, an establishment of the government, is an agency that is meant to collect tax and regulate tax administration of the federal government. Which means Nigerian government relies seriously on the fund being generated by FIRS. But then certain elements decided that the fund should be misappropriated. And that's the essence of this press conference. So we are coalition against corruption and bad governance. It's calling on EFCC and ICPC to commence, and I repeat, to commence immediate investigation of Mohammed Mamman Nami, the incumbent chairman of Federal Inland Revenue Service. Thank you. First of all, let me say this. CACOBAG is not an NGO. It's a mass organization. It's an organization that has no funder, no donor agency, and not affiliated to any person. That is the first thing to be corrected. You see, it's unfortunate. In Nigeria now, NGO, mass organizations, mass movements, and even civil society organizations are mixed up. So that's the first thing. Now, coming back, let me answer the question of Mr. Shaz of CTFM first. One, the names of all these people that were employed by Mamman Nami, we have them. Are you with me? We have them. And not only that we have them, it has been proven and confirmed that he brought in his own loyal people. In fact, one of the directors employed, are you with me, was still running his PhD program at Ahmadu Bello University. But because he's a paddy to Mamman Nami, he was employed. Now, you also talked about maybe he sacked some people or whatever. Well, like I did say earlier on, as far as the FIRS is concerned, it's an establishment, an agent of the government that has autonomy, are you with me, to fire and hire. We leave that one to him. But what we ask, but there's a rule at FIRS, the rule there, that when you have internal staff that have the required qualifications, they must be elevated to the vacant positions. As at that time, there were several deputy directors that had the required qualifications. Let's assume he was not comfortable. We know that all the other positions before he came on board. We cannot decide on that. We give him that benefit of doubt. But then, the presidential directive, and that's why it is mentioned here categorically, You see this HRPP thing. What it says is that whatever, this is the booklet that contains the HRPP orders, rules and law. But it not says in it that any other directive, are you with me, and or circular from the presidency to any of the federal prostate ministry or agencies is also part of that HRPP, and it is binding. One, with this insert the eight directors. Now that circular says before then, before that 2006 or so, if you have been in the service of FIRS for 2 10 years, you must go. But eventually, President Muhammadu Buhari decided to abolish that system, that you can even stay beyond 2 10 years. Though many people were against this as at that time, but other people are against it or not, it is still in force. So what we are saying is that Mr. Mamman Nami did not give consideration to any of those directors. It means all of them are bad. That is what it means. Like that, we give that one to him for benefit of that again. Those internal staff that thought of have been given the opportunity were also not given. Thirdly, it is confirmed that he brought in his own loyal people. We have the names. It is deliberate that we did mention the names here. We are talking about investigation. I want to talk about investigation, holistic investigation, where you are doing in-depth and comprehensive investigation. It means you must go deep, deep down to find out what actually transpired and what happened. So, and that's why we are calling on EFCC and ICPC to do that. In fact, the petition, I will still read it. The petition to ICPC and EFCC, I will read it. You have the opportunity. We says that CACOBAG will be willing to assist EFCC and ICPC further. You see, let me just, as far as CACOBAG is concerned, we don't just raise allegation of corruption against anybody. Why we told the Nigerians, why we told the world that money meant or paid as ransom for Dapsi girls, for the ransom for Dapsi girls that are abducted at that time, that was a fraud. We said it. We told them and gave them the account number where that money was paid to in Germany. So we don't just, because it is here, but by virtue of our law, the law has to be respected. It is EFCC and ICPC that are empowered by our law to do the investigation. As far as that is concerned, Mr. Prisoner of Fraud, yes, you said Mr. Prisoner of Fraud. And Mr. Clement also talked about misappropriation of fund, and I also mentioned about hyperinflation. It is deliberate that we started to say hyperinflated prices. When something is hyper, you know what it means. Everybody, it is clear, everybody knows that this call me, I call you phone, maximally cannot be bought more than, let's say, 10,000 naira. And if somebody is not doing budget, he said this call me, I call you phone is now 550,000 naira. Even without asking anybody, it is clear. We don't look at it and laugh. In some of our areas, everybody here knows how much it costs to dig a borehole. At here, that's why it is most costly. Because of that, the nature of the land over there. Some of our local government chairmen, which we are still coming to them, dug one borehole for as much as 20 million, 25 million naira. What I'm doing is that I'm only trying to give a comparison. That is, even without knowing, without asking people that are experts in digging borehole, you say somebody said he has dug a borehole in Yanopaja here for 25 million or that. Do you need to ask anybody that? You may not talk, you just shake your head, say this one, get a CPO. Is it not true, my brother? All these things are there. It is their record. They have it. And that's what we are saying. If a computer is cost about 200 million naira, then I'm making an assumption. I don't know how much it costs. As somebody starts saying it's 1.3 billion per one. I've not given a exact figure, which he quoted. But what we are saying is that everybody knows this thing, the price was raised for reasons best known to them. You talk about Mr. Babatunde Fowler. Yes, this man considered Mr. Babatunde Fowler. The reason why Mr. Babatunde Fowler is known and clear to all of us as at that time. But that cannot be investigated seriously by us, because the allegation against him by the government, why they remove him, was that the money he made as the chairman of FIRS, forgive me, you know, I've just removed some of my teeth, so pardon me, that the amount of money he made as the chairman of FIRS was not to maybe a certain percentage of what his predecessor in office made. That was the allegation against him. To the best of our knowledge, we didn't have record that to say, yes, this man has done this thing, he has a position. No, we don't know anything about it. But now, we can now say, okay, why tell him why he did not make much money? To him, he said, because of the economy, that one is left for them. But what we are saying, this one that has to do with our money, because this money has already been generated, and somebody is now misappropriating it. And that's an allegation. An allegation cannot be taken to the court of law. It has to be proven. Even some of our comrades, this started at a certain time. I would have comrades here that started to do the investigation and even wrote petition against them. Because what I'm saying is that because it's already been substantiated that those people committed that offense, that they committed the crime, that their hands are not clean. Well, that is the problem. And that is the essence of mass organization. One of among us here, we have one of our organs at United Action for Democracy here with us as well. You see, the system at UAD goes beyond press conference, goes beyond the court. The problem has to be solved on the streets. And that is the problem. That's why some of us are not lacking. But you cannot be blamed. The system in Nigeria has been hijacked. It has been told, somebody mentioned, NGO, every organization is more or less NGO-stick in nature. You see an anti-corruption organization meeting a corrupt element to take money. Somebody did a press conference, tell you that Cyprian Sibra was not corrupt. Somebody did a press conference, tell you that Adebayo Shola was not corrupt. It is very, very funny. You see, when people say absolute power corrupts, it corrupts absolutely. There are some of us, including myself, that believed in the former governor of Osun State, Adebayo Shola, when he was the commissioner. But when he got to that place, I don't know, maybe because of their leader, I don't know the name of their leader. I don't know the system, but something went wrong. Where I'm going is this. We are on our own as an organization. We have not involved ourselves in that investigation or whatever. But I know that a serious, that's an organization, a very serious one, that is fighting Adebayo Shola. Why? And then an organization came out and said, well, this man is not corrupt. The way they said, Cyprian Sibra was not corrupt. My brother, Cyprian Sibra is not corrupt. That is what an organization said. And they did a press conference and they were bold to say it. Like I did say, you see, you cannot just accuse anybody of corruption without investigation. And that's why I said these people ought to be investigated. And I remember that we are saying it is still or less, it is more or less, it is still allegation, because nobody has investigated. Several persons against him, I see their ads, what do you call it, EFCC, that nothing has been done about it. Meaning, as far as Nigeria, since the Nigerian law is concerned, he's still innocent. That's the position. But we, as far as we are concerned, we are saying this Mamman Nami, his hands are not clean. But it cannot be said holistically, except until a proper in-depth investigation is done about his activities at the FIRS. So, I was referring to your question on Mamman Nami, that since 2014, that case has been dragging on. And then I said, that man behind you is my oga, is our oga at UAD. That one sitting behind you directly. You know what we do? Most this type of problem will have been solved on the streets. As far as UAD is concerned, we will that their offices, we will have picketed it. And by the time government says that nothing is working, people are not even moving. they will do the right thing. And that's why, I'm sorry, many of us may not know the essence of human rights law. With human rights in, cases that we drag in the law court for 10 years can be resolved with human rights system within a month. Am I wrong, sir? And that is the essence of human rights law. That's why all of us, we continue to praise Chief Garifari of blessed memory. That's why all of us, we continue to praise Dr. Beko Nasonkuti of blessed memory. People come to the city, want to go to the market, you want to go, you have to have money, you can go to court. If you don't have money, you can do it on human rights, then we do this. And you will be surprised that within a week, you have resolved that issue. If this issue of minor, if as at the time, people are doing what they're supposed to do, UAD will have been on switch. But if nothing is moving, it will have been resolved. So what I'm saying, in essence, my brother, is that we understand the system. When you get to court, this man will plead not guilty. Let's assume he's investigated and find one thing. And by the time he says he's not guilty, his lawyer will come out. They will start different grammar, quoting different laws. Are you with me? Understand? That most of Nigerian problems can be solved on the streets. And that's where I'm going. Even this issue of minor or no minor will have been resolved since. Why are we in this problem, my brother? Why do you think we are here? It's not because of corruption. Nigeria is not supposed to be like this. That's what people don't know. But unfortunately, many of us are not doing what is expected of us. I don't know, maybe we are docile, but because of the economy, because definitely somebody that is hungry, you can ask him to come and protest on the don't look at you, this man, be like, say, you don't know what he did to you. Maybe I never saw since yesterday. We just ignore you. That is the problem we are having. Circumvention of food, yes, I've stated it clearly by our friend here from Sarah Reporter. Yes, we have stated it clearly that lot of rules were circumvented by Mamman Nami. The most important one is failure to advertise that position. The question to ask is why? If not, your motive was involved. That ought to have been advertised. Perhaps my friend from CFM here may have applied to become the director there. Maybe our friends here, maybe one of our people here, may have applied to become a director there. And that's the essence of it. That any, because let me just tell you this thing, as far as this rule is concerned, any vacancy in the federal establishment can be filled by any Nigerian. Are you with me? It's not an appointment that talk about federal character thing. So which means it doesn't matter if everybody that is going to be are going to be Yorubas. But when they were not advertised, my brother, you may not even be aware that there was vacancies at that time. But it happened. Why did they not advertise? So, sir, from the Zara reporters, there are records. Are you with me? And the main reason why we decided to hold this press conference was because of the denial of Mamman Nami. About what things I just decided, I was visibly angry. That which type of person is this? They started denying. Are you with me? They started denying. And given reason why they did certain thing. All these allegations, they gave reason why they said they use a private jet. They gave reason why they said they employed people. Which type of reason is this one? And that was okay. Let's talk about these reasons now. Let us now do it according with the rule of law. EFCC and ICPC, they are empowered to do certain investigation. Let them go and do the investigation to confirm maybe those reasons they have given for why they did or committed those infractions. Maybe they were justified in accordance with the rule of law, in accordance with our instance rule in Nigeria. We are governed by the rule of law. Nobody just does anything anyhow. No. Even when we talk about freedom of speech, you can say anything. But if the government believes that what you have said is against them, or they feel you have done something that it is wrong, they can say, okay, we are inviting you, we are arresting you. They are arresting you. I say, okay, tell us why you have said that. I said this thing because of him. No, I've always told people, President Buhari is not President Buhari. I know you are Major General Buhari, retired, a dictator. So, nothing as good. So, what I'm saying is that as far as the rule of law is concerned in Nigeria, we have the right And that's why some of us, when they are talking about guiding of press by, what do you call that? Mean of, liar. I can't remember the name. Mean of liar. I don't know. You know, lying or not liar. But I know liar day is like his name. When he was talking about guiding of press, I was talking about this man does not know what they are talking about. The Constitution, the grand norm of every Republic of Nigeria has covered every aspect of our law. What the other laws, what the other legal provision and clauses that have is more or less developing what the Constitution has stated. Freedom of press is there. It has not been removed, my brother. There is no law that is superior to it. By force of section 1, subsection 3 of the Constitution, it says any law or any provision that is against the provision of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria is a nullity. It is null and void. So, my brother, so what we are saying, in effect, is that we have records, sir. We have records. We have it. They have it. But, yeah, but EFCC and ICP has expected it is their duty. They must investigate. And after investigation, if it's not found wanting, it should be given a green record of being bet. If it's found wanting, what follows? It must be probed.